and welcome to Science is Solution. I am Manju Sharma, here today again with another video tutorial. Today my topic is cell cycle. But before going into the details of the topic, if you have not subscribed onto my channel, please subscribe it first. And then if you have some hard spots, that means the topics in which you need an explanation, please write to me in the comment box so that I can make videos on your topic next. So let's get started. Cell cycle. Before cell cycle, we must know what is a cell. Cell is the basic structural and functional unit of life or living organisms. This we have studied earlier in our earlier classes. Now, what is a cell cycle? Today's topic is cell cycle. So we should know about cell cycle. It is the life cycle of a cell. Life cycle of a cell, it goes through various phases in a systematic, organized manner in a cyclic way. That is why it is called as a cycle or cell cycle. Now, what are the different stages of the cell cycle? But before going into stages, we must know what are the different contents inside the cell. Now, if it is a eukaryotic cell, it contains a well-defined nucleus. We know eukaryotic cells contain a well-defined nucleus, and inside the nucleus, its genetic material lies. It has certain organelles and it has cytoplasm. Now, before division or before the cell cycle starts or before a cell divides into two parts, first there should be the replication of its organelles, replication of its DNA material, and also its cytoplasm must also be enlarged or it should grow in more amounts, and protein should also be double so that it could double into two different daughter cells. We can see here in cell cycle, one mother cell divides to form two new daughter cells. Now, these two new daughter cells will then act as a mother cell to form two new daughter cells, and this process continues. This is the life cycle of a cell. So when we talk about the different stages of the cell cycle, there are two main stages in the cell cycle. The first one is the interphase, and the second stage is the mitotic phase or the M phase, where the division of the cell occurs. Earlier it was thought that interphase is the resting stage where a division occurs, but actually interphase is the preparatory phase. In this phase, the cell prepares itself for the division. All the preparations like duplication of the DNA, duplication of its organelles, and also cytoplasm also increases in amount. Everything happens in the interphase stage. Now, this preparatory interphase can also be divided into three phases. The first phase is G1 phase. G1 phase or the gap phase 1. In this phase, cell growth occurs. The cell organelles also divide. Cytoplasm increases in amount and more protein are also formed in this G1 phase. So this phase is also called as cell growth phase, or you can say growth phase. Now, the second phase is S phase. S phase. The S phase. S means synthesis. The synthesis of the DNA material takes place in the S phase. This is very important as the nucleus contains the DNA, which is the blueprint of everything in our organism. So everything blueprint, it replicates itself or synthesizes itself in the S phase. That is, DNA synthesis occurs in this phase. The third phase is the G2 phase. G2 phase, again it is the cell growth phase in which growth occurs, cytoplasm increases in amount, more and more proteins are formed, and also cell organelles replicates itself and reorganizes itself to be divided into the two daughter cells. So this G1, S and G2 phase together, they combine and form the interphase. The interphase was earlier thought of as the resting phase where the cell does nothing but it rests. But now it is seen that it is the preparatory phase. It is preparation for mitosis in which growth occurs, cytoplasm increases, protein increases, cell organelles replicate, and also DNA replicates. So it is the main preparatory phase of the cell cycle, that is interphase. Inter means interval, or you can say inter means between. So that means the phase which occurs in between two mitotic divisions, two M phases, that is called as the interphase. Now the next small phase, that is the mitotic phase. In mitotic phase, first the DNA is divided into two different cells or DNA is divided and pulled into two different poles, and then two different cells are formed. That means two different daughter cells are formed distinctly from the mother cell in this mitotic, or you can say M phase. This M phase is further divided into two parts. One is the mitosis phase, and the second one is the cytokinesis phase. In the mitosis phase, the DNA condenses to form the chromosomes, and then they are pulled apart by the microtubules to two different poles of the structure. This happens in various stages like prophase, metaphase, anaphase and telophase, which I will discuss further in other videos. So that is the process of mitosis, in which chromosomes divide and then they are pulled to two different poles, and then the cytokinesis starts. Cytokinesis means division of one cell to form two different cells. Now you see, DNA is pulled into two poles. Now the cell also divided into two poles so that they equally receive the equal amount of DNA. These daughter cells will receive equal amount of DNA from these mother cells. So this is mitotic phase, consisting of mitosis and cytokinesis. So these are the stages of the cell cycle. Let me repeat it. First one is interphase, which consists of three main phases: G1 phase, S phase and G2 phase. The second phase is mitotic phase, and this phase has again two parts, that is mitosis and cytokinesis. In this way, one mother cell divides to form the two daughter cells. Now what happens to these two daughter cells? These two daughter cells' fate depends upon what type of cells they are. If they are the cells of an embryo, or they are the cells like tumor cells, these cells, they divide repeatedly. Mother cells form daughter cells, daughter cell again act as the mother cells to form again daughter cells, again that cells divide to form another cells, and this cycle continues in those cells which undergo repeated divisions. But most of the cells, what happens after certain number of divisions, they stop dividing. So what happens in them is they exit the G1 phase. So after the cytokinesis occurs, they enter into one phase that is called as the G0 phase. So they enter into the G0 phase. In this G0 phase, the cell is in a resting state. That means they are in a resting, that means they will not prepare themselves for mitosis, they will not prepare themselves for further division, but they will carry out their own job. Like for example, a nerve cell or a neuron, if it enters a G0 phase, that means neurons are formed after division and its cell cycle has stopped. So it will enter a G0 phase. So the neuron, after entering a G0 phase, it will carry on its work. It will help to transmit nerve impulses, but it will not divide further. It will not grow further or synthesize DNA or replicate its organelles or DNA and everything. It will not enter the another set of cell cycle, but it will go in a G0 phase. In this G0 phase, it will stay. It will not replicate to form new daughter cells, but it will continue its own job. So this is about the cell cycle and G0 phase. If you have understood the interphase, mitotic division or mitotic phase, and G0 phase, please give the like button. Please like, share and subscribe.